In this slide, we're going to discuss the biphasic and gas productivity index. We know that this formula over there describes the productivity index for a well that would produce oil only. Now, what do I do if I have a well that produces a mixture of oil and water? Over there, I have the productivity index for one well that would produce oil, and over there, the productivity index for one well that would produce water. One thing that I believed for a while is that in that case, my productivity index would be equal to the sum of those two productivity index. Well, unfortunately, it doesn't work that way. So the productivity index for a biphasic well is not equal to the sum of this oil productivity index plus this water productivity index. In reality, the productivity index is going to be smaller than that. Okay, why? Because this term over there represents the productivity index of a well that would produce oil only, and that one if that same well were producing only water. So the sum of those two terms is going to be higher than the productivity index of that well. What you could do is you could choose one skin over there for the oil and one skin over there for the water to fudge it and make this equal. At the end, it doesn't really matter. And what you should understand is when studying the behavior of a well that produces oil and water, while the productivity index formula is not equal to that one, what you see over there gives a good representation of the way your well is going to behave. By that, I mean that you're going to have some change of behavior in your reservoir, in the fluid you produce, and some of these changes are going to bring a higher oil production, like if the value of this term would increase, while some other would bring a higher water production, like if the value of that term over there would have increased. So is the productivity index for a well producing oil and water equal to the sum of those two terms? No, but imagining that it is close to the sum of those two terms will help you to understand how your well behavior change when you have, for instance, a change of water saturation.